take some project. It's gonna take some real fun collab projects. You know what I mean, innit? Like,
yeah, yeah.
Like fan of a fan type projects. Like, yeah. Like certain man just going in for like 2 weeks and then just coming up with the sickest shit that they can come up with that time period. And then next season, and then next edition. We need like a chronology of of Westfield. Does that make sense?
We do. Because I don't think they really know. I think they know drips and drabs. I'm tired of giving it to them in drips and drabs. They need to see the full blast of this thing, what's going on over the West Side.
So when are you dropping? Like, when's Angel's full blast coming? I'm talking like the big body of work, the album. Because as a fan, I'm waiting to hear it. You know what I mean?
You're my bro, you know, like as a fan. Listen, I'm saying, I've always had a lot of records in it, but as you grow and the days go on, you're like, you're creating some new records come and you're like, maybe I want to change this for that, change that for this. But I'm like,
yeah.
Especially now as quarantine, I just release it. Is it like, is it going to be lost in what is happening right now?
That's a real question to make.
People are dying. Like, do we really want to hear that right this second? We're trying to figure out how to get out of our houses and stuff like that.
Sort of, the albums
are always done. I feel like I have lots of material, and I do have favorites, and I do have like the team does have favorites, and we do kind of think about what we are going to put together. But I'm like, if I have it ready today or tomorrow, when will it actually be the right time?
We're living in right now.
That's why I was thinking
the same way with the freestyles that I did. I don't know if you saw, like, I did one called Staying at Home is Long Fam.
Yeah.
And then I did another one called Understand Look Good.
Yeah.
And in my head when I wrote it, I was just thinking, okay, cool. You can go two ways with it. You can either just be savage and be like, I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this. Or you can say, right, like, some people are on furlough, some people have lost their jobs, some people aren't able to leave their country so they can visit where they really come from. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, yo, like, what? If I drop a baby maker tomorrow and the people who are listening can't actually make babies because Mrs. is in a different house.
Right. You have to think about those people. And I think that's very important because sometimes we get lost in the moment on what we have right now in front of us. But there's different sides. There's flip sides to the coin.
We're not making it for ourselves. Right. We're not making it for ourselves. I'm telling you. Speaking of which, yeah, hold on. So there was a team 2013, yeah. It's got Trevor Nelson, got Vicky Toller on it, and I'm a fan of obviously Vicky Toller's voice.
I think that was Gold, the ballad joint. Time out the time.
Hello. Love struck. Can't watch.
So writing wise,
yeah.
There's a part of me that wish I wrote this song. Writing wise. Everything wise. Yeah. I don't
want to make her cry, that's why. Can't believe I went to Stacey Chasing. She don't want to take me back. She promised I wouldn't take me back. No.
Boys in the women. For myself, while I'm out here sleeping. Get to myself, what the fuck was I thinking? She always held me down, she was there from the beginning. Oh, yeah.
That's the good old days. That brings back some memories.
Yeah, I had a young man in Rita. You had an album launch. The album launch was in like a cinema. And we're here in like one track after another track. This was the day to knock the business.
Yeah.
We're going away and break down rhythms in it. So we listen to the song. He's like, what's your rhythm? I'm not going to say the tune that I was featuring on. That's corny. But like, I'm like, yo, you see time after time, yeah? Like, the guy wrote, like he wrote, he went back to the place where like, right, okay, like this is exactly what I know, a certain amount that I'm feeling. And some of them might actually be sure to be able to say it, or some of them may be able to have the penmanship to be like, yo, well, I don't want to leave, but like, it's, yo, like, I could gas this one for a very, very long time.
No doubt, my bro.
But, yeah, like, talking about songs that are like, thinking about people that want feeling and what they're actually feeling in that time period, and so kind of find a way to connect to those. So that they have a soundtrack for this episode that they're going through.
Yeah. Like,
that's a more important thing. We're here for humankind, rather than just here for ourselves to just gas and be like, here's my work, here's the rest. You know? Yeah, bro.
It's mad. It's a big deal. It's mad. What's that drink saying?
Say that again?
What's that drink saying? You nearly downed it, boy. That's nearly done. I know you got.
It's going down.
You
still hear me quietly because people are telling me that my audio's all messed up.
No, it was just like 20 seconds ago, but it's cool.
Oh, you're good now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, six. You know what's mad? Like,
you know what? Do you know what, though? You said something.
Go on.
You said something earlier, and it was like one of our highlights. And we actually didn't actually finish off that topic. So I just wanted to give them a little insight to what you were talking about when you said the Morphire one. Like,
yes.
Time.
Run it.
Well, yay! Oh God. Hey. Here to start something, no drama. We connect to fool, no drama. But I'ma lose my head, oh mama. Sana, come on. Let me whisper in your ear, one more. Do the things I say, no Santa. I'm like, oh papa. More fire, more fire. I can tell the heat is taking over.
Hey.
Moving closer now. We can get the party started over.